Hello everyone, today we are going to begin first prose lesson in your MGGS Rajasthan syllabus called The Best Christmas Present in the World, written by Michael Morpurgo. This story is divided into three parts. In the first part, the narrator of the story buys an old roll-top desk from a junk shop just before Christmas. He finds a letter inside it written in 1914. The second part of the story tells us that the letter is written by Jim McPherson, a school teacher enlisted in the British Army as a soldier, to his wife Connie on December 26, 1914. He tells her how he celebrated Christmas along with the German soldiers, laughing, drinking, and playing football. In the third part of the story, the narrator visits the woman and returns the letter to her. He finds her in a nursing home. She confuses him with her husband and is ecstatic to see him. Thus, the video is also divided into three parts, so make sure you watch all of them to get a complete understanding of the story. Let's start part first. I spotted it in a junk shop in Bridport, a roll top desk. Spotted means sight. Junk shop, a shop selling miscellaneous second hand or old out of use material. Bridport is a small market town in Dorset, England. Roll top desk is a writing desk. You can see in the picture a roll top desk. The man said it was early 19th century and oak. The narrator of the story went to a junk shop. He wanted to buy a roll top desk. And the seller told him that it belonged to early 19th century and was made of oak. He had wanted one, but they were far too expensive. The narrator wants to buy one and they were very costly. Expensive means costly. This one was in bad condition. The roll top in several pieces. One leg clumsily mended. Clumsily mended means unskillfully repaired, as if by someone unskillful. Scotch marks. Scotch marks mean burn marks. All down one side. It was going for very little money. The roll top desk was in poor shape. The roll top desk was not in a single piece. One of its legs was unskillfully repaired and it had burn marks on one of its side. Because of it being old and the condition in which it was available for a very cheap price, I thought I could restore it. Restore means repair. It would be a risk, a challenge, but I had to have it. I paid the man and brought it back to my workroom at the back of the garage. The narrator believed that he could repair it even though it was not an easy task. Thus, he bought it by paying the shopkeeper and took it to home. He took it to his workroom, which was at the backside of his garage. I began to work on it on Christmas Eve, and he started mending it on the eve of Christmas. I removed the roll top completely and pulled out the drawers. The veneer had lifted almost everywhere. Veneer means a thin layer of plastic or decorative wood on furniture of cheap wood. It looked like water damage to me. Both fire and water had clearly taken their toll on this desk. Taken their toll on means damaged. The last drawer was stuck fast. Stuck fast means shut tight. The desk was in very bad condition and it appeared to him that water and fire had clearly done enough damage. The fact that all the decorative wood was coming out of it made it clear that it could be water damage. He removed the roll top completely and started taking out the drawers. While all the drawers came out, the last one was shut tight. I tried all I could to ease it out gently. In the end, I used brute force. Brute force means a lot of force, like an animal-like force. I stuck it sharply with the side of my fist and the drawer flew open to reveal a shallow space underneath, a secret drawer. He tried to pulling it gently, but when he did not succeed, he had to use extreme force to take it out. So he punched the drawer with the side of his fist and it flew open. There was something in there. I reached in and took out a small black tin box. Sellotaped on the top of it was a piece of lined notepaper and written on it in shaky handwriting, Jim's last letter received January 25, 1915, to be buried with me when the time comes. In the secret drawer there was a black tin box inside it. On its top side of the tin box there was a note on which it was written, Jim's last letter received January 25, 1915, to be buried with me when the time comes, in a shaky handwriting. I knew, as I did it, that it was wrong of me to open the box, but curiosity mean eager to know, got the better of my scruples. Scruples means feelings that makes you hesitate to do something wrong. It usually does. He knew in his heart that it was wrong for him to open the box, but curiosity somehow got the better of him, the way it generally does, and he opened it. Inside the box there was an envelope. The address read, Mrs. Jim McPherson, 12 Copper Beaches, Bridport, Dorset. I took out the letter and unfolded it. It was written in pencil and dated at the top, December 26, 1914. He found an envelope inside the tin box. When he opened it, there was an address written on it. It read, Mrs. Jim McPherson, 12 Copper Beaches, Bridport, Dorset. The narrator took out the letter, unfolded it, and began reading. It was written on December 26, 1914. Now it's time to comprehension check. What did the author find in a junk shop? What did he find in a secret drawer? Who do you think had put it in there. Dear students, that's all for today. Watch video part 2nd and 3rd for rest of the story, its explanation and question answer. The link will appear in description box below this video.